Happy Death Day to You is the sequel to Happy Death Day, which only came out about a year and a half ago. It came out October 2017. It's crazy how they can churn these movies out so quick. This is another Blumhouse film. It's the first one, you know, it was like a slasher film meets Groundhog Day. I enjoyed the first film. I didn't hate it. Didn't really love it. I remember, I think in my review, I said something about, you know, it's worth checking. If this was like a Netflix movie, I would understand. There was some really cool things about it. And, you know, it's kind of the same here again. The second film, I didn't hate it. I didn't love it. You know, it is for different reasons this time. Because this time they go in a more scientific route. They try and explain why she keeps reliving the same day, or why this new person is reliving the same day. And then we get even deeper into it. We go into kind of like parallel universes and things. So they definitely go a different route with this one. It's one of my biggest fears with this film was I was like, because in the trailers it almost seemed like you were reliving the same day again, which you kind of are, but they did it in a way where it wasn't like super repetitive or the same shtick again. This time almost there's not really a whole lot of horror elements to it. I mean, there's still a few slasher moments, but for the most part it's kind of a sci-fi comedy now. There's a lot of comedy in it, and for the most part the comedy works. Jessica Roth once again is the main highlight. All the supporting cast, no one really sticks out, and sometimes the supporting cast in this one is a little bit cheesier and a little bit worse than they were in the first one. But Jessica Roth is great. It's got a lot of humor. It's got a lot of heart this time. They go into her past and certain things in this one that will really tug at the heartstrings. And I enjoyed that stuff for the most part. I will say this one gets a little bit convoluted, whereas the last one, I felt like it was super easy to predict and they kind of tricked you into who the killer was. This one goes kind of another route where it's just getting a little too convoluted and a little bit messy. But the adding of the heart and Jessica Roth is pretty good and it's funny. So I don't know. It's kind of a crapshoot. If you really like the first movie, you're probably really going to like this one. If you're like me and you just thought the first movie was okay, you're probably going to think the same thing here. I will say, towards the end of this movie, I'm starting to get bored and I'm starting to check my watch. So, you know, I don't know. They do set up for a third one, and I don't know if how many more of these I can really take. I'd probably go see one more, but, you know, I don't know. It's kind of not really doing it for me on a real awesome level. But other than that, I mean, they can churn them out for cheap and make a decent buck, so why not? It was pretty good. If you liked the first film, you're probably going to dig this one. I'm going to give Happy Death Day to You a 3 out of 5, which is the same exact score I gave the first film, because it's I probably enjoyed it equally as much. Until next time, this is Rainy Cage. Peace out.